What a journey. Good afternoon, Garry Meier on the Big 720. I am your permanent host of this slot, as permanent as anything is these days. I am ecstatic to be here. Thank you for your support. It's always meant a lot to me over the years, and I will never forget that. Believe me. Believe me. I want to put a phone call on the air right away because this guy's been on hold for a while, and I'll just start off with Dean. Hello, Dean.
Hey, Garry. Congratulations.
I'm not going to make a lot of people call and go, I'm just putting you on because I just want to say hello to you. I am so happy to be back on the air.
Absolutely, and it's good to hear you, and that's why I told the producer that I want to have the honor of congratulating you and being your first caller.
Well, I just wanted to put that on to say thank you, Dean. I am back, and I am honored that you're my first call.
And I will be listening.
I wish I had a rain hat or some kind of thing to give you from the WGN closet.
No worries,
the ladybug wristwatch, the door chimes, but I guess that's all gone. But Dean, yes. Get ready. We're going to have a good time if it's the last thing I do.
Absolutely.
And if it's the last thing I do, I'm going out like Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid this time. Trust me.
I'm looking forward to it.
Thank you, Dean.
Thank you, brother.
Appreciate it. All right. I have to say at the outset, I want to thank my wife and daughter for supporting me over the last, well, since I've met them, and I met my daughter when she was born. But this has been an adventure in the last 5 years that I will get into in bits and pieces over the next few months, I guess. But they have been tremendous supports in this whole configuration. And it has not been easy, believe me. And I am not pandering to you who are unemployed. I have been there, and I can say, hang in there. I know it's tough, and I was no day at the beach a lot of those months, believe me. And my wife and daughter were there and took my mind off a lot of this nonsense. And I hope you have that support system as much as I've had it over the years, because it is tough out there. It is really tough. I don't think any of us have ever seen anything like this, unless you're of a certain age who experienced the Depression, but that group is probably a small part of the universe right now. But it is tough out there, and I can feel for what you have been going through and are going through if you're still unemployed. Hang in there, and I'll try to help you along here if I can do anything between 1 and 4 every afternoon to make it a little less depressing. I'll be glad to do that. But I have to step out for just a second here from something that I usually ignore. And over the years, I kind of shrug stuff off and think, well, you know, I'm considering the source, da-da-da. But there was something in the paper today, and I'm tired of it, and I'm going to address it, because I found through all these years that if you let somebody slap you around and you don't respond, they think you like it, and they keep slapping you. So I am responding to this today because I have had it. I don't mind criticism. I'm not above criticism, believe me. I've taken plenty over the years. That's fine. It comes with the territory. But this was in the Sun-Times today in Louis Lazar's column. And I'm just going to address this right now. First of all, he said in this column, he's talking about the 8 years I was at WLS with Ro Khan, and it says here, in a move that perplexed many local radio observers, Meier refused in 2004 to resign a multi-million-dollar contract to continue working with Khan. Meier has never explained why he walked away from that deal. Yes, I did. I don't know, Lewis doesn't read anything, apparently, and I'm not going to bore you with those details anymore. That's 5 years ago. Okay, why do you care, Lewis? How did it hurt you? Okay, I paid the price for whatever reason. It was my decision. I'm happy with it, and I remain happy with it. But that's not what I'm really angry about. Meier's agent, who was also his wife, was rumored to be pushing hard for a salary in the neighborhood of $1 million. But WGN management staunchly resisted. That is a total lie. And I want you to produce some documentation that shows me that, or somebody that said that here. Show me. That is a total lie. Okay, and my wife has been slapped around in these things. She has been nothing but supportive, and she orchestrated this deal and the last one at WCKG, and she did a great job. By the way, Lewis, you can't trust your wife to do something for you and trust whatever she does, then what's that all about? I shouldn't trust my wife to have my best interest in mind? So what is your point? This is insane, but that is totally false, okay? It's a total lie. I don't know where you got it. Show me the documentation, buddy, all right? I want to see it. Produce it. I'll put you on this show. But I'm just sick of that crap because you let people slap you around and they just keep slapping you like, oh, he loves it. And I have learned one thing, I think at least one thing in the last 30-some years. People will try to get away with stuff. And we've seen it, well, we see it every day in our government or whatever. And once they get away with something like whatever, they start getting away with more and more. And then suddenly we're in this hole. And I'm surprised more people aren't angry about a lot of things right now, I'll be honest with you. And when I was on a month ago and did those 4 days and I got off the air and my mother said, wow, you sound like you're all wound up about something. I said, Mom. And then she said, when I talked to Bob Surratt yesterday, she said, well, that Bob Surratt's got good pacing. I go, okay, Mom, thank you. But I don't know why more people aren't angrier, because we're in a hole here that we, for the most part, didn't create. There are just a few people who made this hole for us and pushed us in. And I think it's time that somebody said something about something instead of just sitting here and going, oh, well, that's the way it goes. So Louis Lazar said something today is totally false, and I don't get it. I don't know where he got that. I called the guy back several times over the last month when he called me. I returned his calls, had a nice conversation with him, I thought, yesterday. But I don't know what this guy's problem is. Is he working off the playbook from the mope that had the column before? I mean, what did I do to this guy? Russ, we got some news.
Yes, ABC News is now reporting that it has learned that the gunman involved in the shooting in Binghamton, New York, has killed himself. So apparently the ordeal is over. This began a couple of hours ago in Binghamton, and this man stormed a building and had some people, we believe dozens actually, held hostage for quite some time. Over the period of time, we know some people were released, but there were also reports of as many as 13 shot and killed, several others wounded. The story is continuing to develop. We'll have more coming up at 1:30, but it appears to be over, with the gunman having taken his own life. Back to you, Garry.
Thank you, Wes. How about that story that keeps rotating around, it seems like, every year now? It is frightening out there. You go to school, and then you're dead. Life is so fragile, and I know this comes off as a cliche, but my God, and this Natasha Richardson thing, I think a lot of people stopped and went, okay, you're on the bunny hill, and then you're dead 24 hours later. And that, I don't mean to sound facetious, that's kind of how it is. It's so much on a thread, and you can't even go to school without some maniac bursting in and killing you. Listen, I want to have a good time here. That's my goal, but there is so much out there that I cannot believe. I wake up and I go, but I have to start slapping back, because I've been stepped on too many times, and that's not a whine. I'm just tired, and most of the time I was without a format. I'd be sitting at home seeing something in the paper that was totally untrue, and I had no format, so I had to sit there and take it. But I'm not taking it anymore. I don't think any of us should. I think we should start fighting back and get the stuff back that was ours, whatever that is, our bank accounts, our houses, or whatever. I've had it, and that's not going to be the tone of this program every day. But I'll tell you what, I'm just surprised more people aren't angrier. And we talked about the parking meter situation here a month ago when I was on, because I saw that already brewing, and then it blew up in the last few weeks. And I'm going to get into that, too, about this Olympic fever here and this and that. I really don't think we should have the Olympics for a lot of reasons, and I'm not trying to be a fly in the ointment here. But I think there are some things we have to look at and then go, okay, then we should go after the Olympics. But I don't think we should, because there are more problems here right now that need to be taken care of. And this parking meter thing, I think, was the tipping point. So that's what I want to get into. 312-591-7200. Hi, how are you? This is the Happy Station. I know it doesn't sound like it, but it is. Now, Linda, what can I do for you?
Hi. I just wanted to welcome you to WGN.
Thank you.
And to let you know that I appreciate you setting the record straight, because it is your life that these people are spreading lies and rumors about. But I wish that you would take a deep breath and just realize that this is the first day of a new life.
Yes.
A new chapter in your life, that WGN is a wonderful place to be. I am so glad that you are at WGN, and I wish you well. And I'm very sorry that you have to deal with this on the very first
I am too,
there.
But you know what? Over the years, my policy has been, if you've been a listener of mine, to ignore this stuff. And the problem is, Linda, when you ignore things, and this is a bigger picture. This isn't just me getting a little criticism in the newspaper. This is about the whole situation this country is in right now. We let these mopes in Washington do stuff, and we just let it go, and now they go, well, it's your problem. You bail out the car companies. You bail out this and that. You bail out the bankers. And we were just sitting here working or trying to work, and this is what happens. We got to speak up a little more and tell these people either do something right or get the hell out of Washington and let somebody do it that can do it. And this is, listen, right here in Illinois, we got this mope ex-governor now who's been indicted, and we got to deal with that. And I'm thinking, really, this indictment, the stuff they've got him in this indictment charged with, it's unbelievable.
I know. Too many people have let wrong go by without speaking up, and you're speaking up.
Well, I'm not going to make this my little soapbox about my life. Again, I don't mind criticism. I've taken it for a long time, but I'm going to defend things that need to be defended if it's blatantly untrue, and that was blatantly untrue, and I want to get that off the table, and we're going to move on to other things, because I got to talk about the ShamWow guy. The ShamWow guy was in trouble a few weeks ago. My God. And I've got a new invention kind of for, well, that involves the ShamWow. So, okay. Linda, I'm here to have as much enjoyment as we can have, and that might get a little rough at sometimes because there's a lot of weirdness out there, but overall, I'm here to have a good time.
Well, thank you for setting the record straight. I do appreciate that.
Thank you, Linda. Okay. All right, thank you. All right, I'll take more calls, and we'll get into some other stuff, including I'd like to see if the South Suburban town of Harvey would like to sell its name. I'm trying to help here. The economy is a little wrecked. I'm trying to help, and I want to see if they are willing to sell the name of the town to a retailer or a product and maybe get them back on their feet, because I know Harvey because I went to junior college there. A junior college is a high school with ashtrays. I know that.